what is going on. I would like to start with what's happening here in America. So I have lived in America for the last 32 years, and I never had to ever tell any of my Hindu friends ever that what my caste was. Nobody ever asked me. I've had all kinds of religious rituals done in my house, and I've asked my Hindu friends. They were very happy to come and join me, and never was an issue. The reason that I myself had to finally come out as a Dalit was forced by something that happened in California called the Cisco case, where they accused a certain person to be discriminating against a Dalit person. And when I saw what was written in that case, it was shocking to me because they wrote it as a Dalit. They described a Dalit as usually a dark-skinned, oppressed, uneducated person that is being taken advantage by upper caste. Now, has the oppression happened? Yes. Has oppression happened in many different levels? And we can talk about that. Yes. But that has nothing to do with what in America these people are sitting and talking about, something that they have no idea about. So it was a very, shocking to say the least. So I started looking for a way to be a part of it so that we can really fight it. This is nothing but a hatred towards a community that is already minuscule in number. We are the minority of the minorities. And why would you, when there are so many problems that we can tackle in America, that you're looking for something that's so minuscule that doesn't affect even 0.0001% of the population? Why has that become center stage in California? So that's when I started looking for a way that I can express my views and do something for the community. I ended up finding Kona and Nikunji. They were very gracious enough to take me in their wings and see what else I can contribute as a person. And when I first joined, they were just basically talking about this issue, the Cisco issue as well. And they were saying, we are having issue and we need somebody who can vocally speak about these things. And then I said, well, I'm a Dalit, I can speak about it. And then I went and we started reaching out to people so we can give our side of the story as well. We don't want to deny others, but we need to have our side of the story. So when we started telling our story, we called a very prominent newspaper here. They basically very happily accepted. And then we gave an interview and nothing happened. They just closed the book and they didn't want to hear anything about it. We went to several meetings of the certain county here. I don't know if I can mention the county name, but I don't know if it is relevant. But anyway, when we went there, I basically asked them, what do you know about anything caste? If there are 10 Indians sitting, can you just pick by a person looking at a person who is a Dalit? And what if tomorrow I don't like you and I'm going to come and say, he discriminated against me, I'm a Dalit. How are you going to prove who is a Dalit? How? What are you going to do? In India, they're going to get a certification saying, because in India, there are certain part of South that a certain community is seen as lower caste, where if you go in another southern state or in Bihar or Uttar Pradesh are not considered a lower caste. How are you going to deal with this? So they were puzzled. They decided, okay, we have to look into it and we will discuss this. And we actually had another meeting. And there was one small victory for us where they said, okay, we won't make this as an issue, but we will definitely add something so that if there is a discrimination lawsuit comes in, we have to deal with it. And the whole point about this is no Hindu will ever stand up and go, oh, I am against it just because it says this is oppression. No, this is not what we're saying. We're saying you cannot isolate a community and say these people are by birth, by nature, are this way. This is wrong. That is what we're saying. And I have been a receiver of wonderful gifts from entire community. I have been to my Hindu temple as I was myself walking away from Christianity and learning about Hinduism. I was so welcomed in our local temple, Shiva Vishnu temple in where I live in California. And they were wonderful. They never asked me what caste I was. I was included in while volunteering for the temple, doing worship of the deities. I was in the front lines to doing stuff. So these kind of things that they're creating fear of the Hindu people and hatred of Hindu people without knowing them. See, you only fear people who you don't know or things you don't know. So you, if they're interested, they should be open to what we have to say. They cannot make decisions based on what they are thinking about a community that they have no clue about. Like what Kudikunji was saying, when my son brought a social studies book, I was appalled. There was basically a page of story of India and four paragraphs were about the Mughals, two paragraphs about British. And the rest of whatever Hinduism that they talked about is caste. That's it. So I had to go to the school and tell them, this is not what India is about. And who is writing these books? So this systematic way of somehow, either they're deliberately doing this because there is an agenda, or because they don't care because there's not enough Hindus standing up and saying, we don't accept this. This is not who we are. And this is very important, because until we stand up and claim our own narrative, there will always be somebody telling our story. And that is very important. The problem that is happening now is that if they can somehow divide us into certain people, then it will be easier for them to make up whatever they want to about us. And that has been the problem. It was very shocking for me. We went to another meeting. There were 35 people who wanted to support the caste as a category of discrimination to be included in the University, California University. 35 people, out of which 30 of them all sat there and said that they're Savarnas, they're oppressed, and they all speak in American English accent. None of them I could tell grew up in India. And these people are sitting, they all call themselves Savarnas, and they're all saying that our people oppress these people, so that's why we want to add this. My question to you, who are sitting there and saying, first of all, you cannot qualify as yourself as an oppressor if you're saying that class should not exist, number one. Number two, if that is true, where are these people that you oppressed? In America, where are they? Why are you speaking for them? Do they not have a voice? Are they not educated enough? Or do you think that you still have to somehow control the narrative of these people so that you can become the shepherd and you always have these people as sheep? These are the questions that we have to ask. Why can't a Dalit sit and say the things that you're saying? And you know, of 1.2 billion Indians, these useless people could not find one Indian Dalit. They had one so-called Nepali Dalit on their panel. And you know who else was their speaker? Audrey Trushke, who self-proclaimed South Asian expert, speaking hatred, spewing hatred, saying, oh, I am a South Asian expert and I can tell you Hinduism about oppression. What do you know about it? You spend a whole day singing Sahasranama of Babur and Aurangzeb. How would you know anything about Hinduism? How do you know? So these are the problems that we've been facing. And the one thing that I would like to urge strongly, see, if you see these leftists, whoever they call, I don't like calling them leftists, but these people who claim on the other side, they're the same people who will sit on a Saturday with 10 of their friends with a glass of wine in their hand and watch Downton Abbey and sing the glory of these people doing atrocity, oppression of their own people. Worse than what happened to Dalits stuck in the basement serving these people. Nobody will have any problem today. In the 2021, they will sit and talk about this and somehow it is beautiful because they have a wine in their hand. But if they truly believe that oppression happens, they would not be sitting and watching that show. So these are the problems that we have to see. These people neither care for the Dalit nor for any causes. It's just their Saturday evening talking point so they can feel good about themselves. If these people wanted to come and sit and talk about what oppression has happened, if they have a problem, if their parents were that terrible, I'm sorry, then they should go and get a therapy or go to a confession in a Catholic church and confess all the problems that they have. So these are the problems that we are facing, and we have to unite and we have to fight this and take the narrative back in our hand. And this is why it is important for us to tell our story from our own experiences and where we are today and take back that narrative. And we tell them who we are. We will see, I always say this one, and I will say this one and conclude. When I came to America in the beginning, even though I was raised as a Christian, my Christian family did not eat beef when I was growing up. Did not eat beef. So when I came to America, they would ask me, why you don't eat beef? Why you don't eat beef? And I would give all kinds of reasons, like civilizational reason, religious reason. Nothing was important. They would accept it. You know what that stopped them from asking that question? You try this. This is what we have to start doing today. Academic work is fine, but as a foot soldiers, we need to do this. If somebody ever asks you why you don't eat beef, don't answer. Tell them why you don't eat cat and dog, the same reason we don't eat beef. And that is the narrative on the street that we have to have. Do not let them question you. Do not let them put you on defensive. We have to tell them we will work on the same level. We will ask questions just like you will ask questions. My favorite mantra is from Niti Shastra. It says, yasyam nasti swayam pragnyam. Shastram tasyam karoti kim. If a person does not have self-conscious, if he doesn't understand himself, shastras will not help him. So we need to bring ourselves, our consciousness, so that way we can explain others who we are. And I think that is important. And I just wanted to end by saying that. Thank you so much for giving me the opportunity.